again for another thriller. Like, subscribe, comment, give it all to me, baby. You understand? I love it. I appreciate y'all for watching my videos. I'ma continue doing them because I know you love me and I love you. Okay? So what we got going on today is a little Clemson football. We all saw the smashing last night, Alabama versus Clemson. Nobody called that. Nobody. If you say you called that, you're a damn lie. And you know it. I'm not saying you didn't have Clemson winning, but by how much? Not no 44-16. That's something we've never seen. So the question of the day is, has Clemson take over Alabama as the number one college football program in the nation? Okay? Let's check out this first take ish, man. This dead man Dooley on the beat.
Clemson, to me, saved college football last night. And I'm not engaging in hyperbole by saying that. Because all we've been talking about is Alabama. We remember the 35-point South Carolina dropped on Clemson. We remember how Syracuse gave them a run for their money, losing 27-23. We remember Texas A&M dropping 26 on them earlier this year in Jimbo Fisher's first year. We saw those things. We looked at the schedule and we said, you know what? Clemson's a good team, but Alabama's on another level. What Dabo Swinney showed us last night is that he's been waiting all year long to coach against this man, Nick Saban, and the Alabama Crimson Tide. And so when I look at it from that perspective, and I'm thinking about the monopoly that Alabama has had over college football, and now you've got Clemson, who's won two national titles within the last 4 years, going up against Alabama all 4 years, I think it's sensational for college football. And I also think in this sense, last night, there was a positive and a negative, believe it or not, to Nick Saban. The positive is that when you get annihilated like that, all of this stuff, no matter how much they're winning.
Man, hold on right there real quick, Stephen A. Honestly, this was what we like to call a shellacking of epic proportions. Okay? It's something that just doesn't happen. Not to Alabama. Okay? It was unexpected, everybody. Okay? But to say Clemson is now the number one college football program? Absolutely not. Yes, they've beaten Bama twice. I get it. But Bama has also beaten them twice. Okay? So, let me continue this footage. This that man. You understand?
By how Nick Saban stays on everybody, how he's known as a curmudgeon to some degree, constantly berating, constantly going after it, so intense, never a lax moment. We have just, you know, we've decried that from time to time. We see now why he's that way, because you can never take any time off. You can never assume anything. You can never take anything for granted. And that's an incredible lesson for them to learn. That's the positive. The negative, however, is that when you look at Saban, it's like, wow, to lose like that and to get out-coached, like you pointed out, Marcus, that is a bad, bad moment. This is a bad day for Nick Saban because the invincibility clearly, you know, it's been stripped, no doubt.
It's terrible, Stephen A., and I agree with you. But I got to go back to Max. Max, who has the other two national championships?
Alabama.
Okay. All right. So we saw a game last night that was very lopsided, and I want to give Clemson all the credit that they deserve. They deserve to have a lot of credit in this game for what they did on the field. Max, but you're not that guy. You're living in the moment right now. All right, think about what happened to Clemson last year. And everybody was and this was an anemic Alabama offense that Clemson lost to last year. I give Dabo credit for making the move to Trevor Lawrence. They had a senior-laden defense. Nobody's talking about Cleveland Farrell, Austin Bryant, Christian Wilkins, and Dexter Lawrence all might be going to the NFL next year. So we continue to talk about Clemson, and yes, they will be back. They'll be a very good team. But now they're about to start going through the same rigors that Alabama has been going through. They're about to start losing.
I'm not saying they took it from.
Let me say something about this Clemson team. Honestly, they're the number two team in the nation for a reason. Number one, just won the national championship. Still not a better program than at Nick Saban in Alabama. Ever. Okay? Now, when you talk about this Clemson team, I don't see another program in college football right now better than that Clemson team, besides Alabama. And I'm just keeping it 100. Clemson, they've been in the neck of things. They got two national titles out the last 4 years just to prove themselves. It's like, honestly, what can any of us say about this Clemson team? You know? Now let's continue the footage, man.
I'm saying, look, since 2015, Alabama and Clemson, same record, 55-4, same playoff appearances, four, same titles, too. So what I'm saying is they caught them. They're in the playoff era. If you extend it behind, in the playoff era, they're even. And now I'm saying I favor Clemson going forward because they have the best quarterback in college football, who is a true freshman this year and that has that experience, and they return a tremendous number of freshmen and sophomore players, and you can see Dabo Sweeney head-to-head with Nick Saban as at least his equal in the last, you know, 4 or 5 years. So what I'm saying is at this
Max,
it could all be over.
Max, let me ask you this. At any point during the year, did you say Tua Tagovailoa was the best quarterback in college football?
Early on, yes.
Okay, so we saw the performance by Trevor Lawrence last night.
It was more than early on.
Nope.
Yes, it was. You've been saying it all year.
No, Trevor Lawrence has been the presumptive best quarterback.
Max over there jaws it. They got you, Max. They got you. Dead man.
Everybody
has. For weeks and weeks and weeks.
Whatever. I'm
Everybody
not
has said to a tongue about
I've been right
was the best
you.
Quarterback.
That's not true.
Paying attention.
That's not what you said. Go ahead.
The conversation was between Tua and Kyler. All right. And the reason why I'll give you some background analysis on me, because I'm like both of you guys. I'm easy to admit when I'm wrong. Since 2007, a freshman quarterback hadn't beat Nick Saban. And I looked at this game and I said to myself, yes, Trevor Lawrence has been great. Yes, Trevor Lawrence was the move that Dabo made to make this team better and push them forward as far as pushing the ball downfield because he knew he would have to have a passing game. That move was made because Tua Tagovailoa was at Alabama. I don't care what Dabo Sweeney says. He understood that was a step he would have to take in order to compete. But everybody now is saying Trevor Lawrence is the better quarterback. Look, Trevor Lawrence has a bright future. He'll probably be the first pick of the NFL draft in 2020 in his junior year. But let's not forget, because of last night, what the conversation revolved around all season long.
Stephen A. is intimating that
Let me be honest. Trevor Lawrence, we call him Sunshine, by the way. So, good old Sunshine, you know. And you don't know football if you don't know what I'm talking about. Remember the Titans, baby. Denzel Washington. Anyways, So, good old Sunshine, true freshman, slinging the rock like John Elway. You know? Come on, man. I'd rather have him over any quarterback in the nation right now. Okay? I can't even say the Alabama quarterback's last name, for God's sake. Okay? Heard it about a million times. Still can't say it. Anyways, let me continue this good old footage one time. It's that man.
You're doing revisionist history here. No, I think that's actually revisionist history. Tua, to start the season, certainly was considered the best. And Tua, certainly on the Alabama team, seemed to give them something that Jalen Hurts didn't. It's like now it's just unfair because they have this great quarterback. And we all think he's great. He's going to be great on the next level, too, all that. But about halfway through this season, Trevor Lawrence took over as the consensus guy who eventually would probably be the number one pick and was probably the best player. The issue with him was that he was a true freshman. He didn't have the experience. That was the issue.
Well,
so that was a surprise that he could do that as a true freshman.
First of all, I beg to differ in terms of engaging in revisionist history. What I'm saying to you is I'm not saying you talk down about Trevor Lawrence. I'm saying you barely ever mentioned him. It was Marcus was right. It was about Tua. Let's see. They can find a tape because I'm telling you, I don't even recall you talking about Trevor Lawrence. But that's neither here nor there.
And
nobody did. And that's fine.
That's not true.
I'm just telling you.
Okay,
that's a fine tape because I'm telling you, I don't recall. All right, now
exactly.
Marcus Spears, let
point.
Me get back
Nobody
to you.
Because,
I don't, hold on, wait, it's okay. Not that important right now. It's not that important.
Man, that's enough of the footage, man. You see what happened? Bama got the bricks beat off him, okay, by a Clemson team, 44-16, $44. Okay, anyways. So, Bama gets beat. And now everybody's saying Clemson is the best team, the best college football program in the nation. No, they're close number two. They still have not done what Nick Saban and Alabama has done within this last decade. Please. Good two wins though, Clemson. That was a great whooping. We all loved it. Sometimes you gotta love seeing Bama get whooped, okay? But I had him last night. Okay? But anyways, I appreciate you for watching the footage. Bama's still the number one school to go to in the nation. Clemson number two. Okay? Good win, Clemson. This that man Dooley. Like, subscribe, comment, tell me how you feel, baby. That man.